Great, you're very kind, thank you. Thanks for having faith in this, evening. yeah, that would be nice. We'd stay here until October 1st, no problem. But, probably going to sing until the end of September 30th. Yeah, okay, this song. Here's a song. Songs and all. This is a song about it's about kind of the Irish, it's about sort of the Irish story of immigration and the one thing that sort of unites everybody in the planet, I guess, hope for a better life, hope for a better future. And so everyone's moving towards the best case scenario in their, I suppose, in their hearts and in their heads and in their lives. And so this is just about anybody who's, you know, well, anybody who's moving towards a new life. We, after the famine, the Irish came. Well, I guess we came as far as the East Coast, and then maybe we slowly made our way towards the West Coast. Maybe there was some early people that I know that people that I know stayed on the East Coast. We went to England, Australia. This is for all of. Well, I guess it's just for all of you. You can't sing a song about immigration without singing about everybody, because everybody's on the move. They're not on the move now. They were. They're not on the move now. They will be. This is just for anybody who's not from LA, but maybe who lives here and works here. And,
Amen.
Across the deserts in our caravan, way back in the way that went.
same nothing. Sydney and Auckland, and I was reading Leonard Cohen's wonderful biography by Sylvie Simmons, I'm Your Man, and I really was felt so inspired reading that book. I was writing a lot while reading it. It was on the holding a battery. The book was just so filled with just electricity that I just found myself writing a lot. And I was really trying to write a song. I would have loved to have written a song to tribute Leonard because I was so in love with him at the time and since a kid. And I realized that Leonard Cohen is just way too big a subject to try to, you know, he's a mountain. So I needed to pick a rock on the edge of the mountain and sing about that. And so I picked the word mercy, just the tiny word that Leonard uses so well. When he speaks of the word mercy in the book, it just rings in a different way. And sometimes it's when you get a word in your mouth and you roll it around, sometimes several different avenues of thought come on just from one word. And so that one got caught in my head, and I stayed with it. And so this is a song called Mercy, Her Mercy, which is just a song about, I guess, kind of understanding between people. So it's my way, by attributing one word, my way of attributing Leonard, which is just, hit the song is to a tiny rock on the edge of the mountain that is Leonard Cohen.
And you're worthy
when y'all asleep around the back door, and she's waiting patiently for you no more. And when you're ready for her mercy and your word, in my way to be free.
worm on a hook, like a knife from some old-fashioned book. I've saved all my ribbons for thee. If I have been unkind, I hope that you can just let it go by. If I have been untrue, I hope you know that it was never.
All right, folks, this is going to be the last song. Thank you very, very much for your wonderful kindness. Sometimes you try to write an Amy Winehouse song and you end up with this. Songs are funny. I sort of go,
I'm not doing that.
This song kind of came more or less fully formed in a moment at Doug's house a few years ago. Doug was showing me his vocoder. And I'd only really, you know, Phantom Live is the only experience I'd have, you know, what that said. And I started playing, and immediately we had a song. I'm really glad that you pressed record. I'm just glad. So this is a song called It's a Fool's Game. And I guess it started as a kind of,
you know, it's a fool's game.
And it ended up in a different place, but with not having the full band here tonight, it'll be a slightly different thing again. But this is all about the blood and guts of it all, and the heart is a mysterious engine. The song is all about how the head and the heart are. Actually, I was telling this story the other night, and it was a guy from the band, the head and the heart. You know, the head is, the heart is driven by nature, and nature breaks its own rules all the time, so there's no knowing it, there's only experiencing it. And so the heart is natural and the head is logical and rational, and this song is sort of trying to describe in some ways how the head is on the phone to the heart, and the phone is ringing, he's up in the attic and he wants to talk to the heart about something important, and the heart isn't answering the phone, the heart doesn't have a phone, the heart doesn't know what a phone is. And so it's about that kind of, that they're in the same body but they don't talk. And so this is all the messiness of love, and how we end up in all kinds of complication when we try to rationalize nature that's just doing its own thing. So it's neither one of the other is right or wrong, but it's all part of the same thing.
Yeah.
It's a fool's, fool's game, lover, that we have to play, crashing into each other, no convalescing. It's a leap of faith, lover, that we blindly. Well, I'm taking it with you and no other, no hesitation. And if our minds they go and our bones they shatter, we'll put it on nobody but us.
you know.